Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Objects on a Path tool, which is one of the new features in Adobe Illustrator 2025. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the new tool, how Illustrator orders the objects that it places on the path, how it places them on the path, and finally, how you can edit those objects once they're on a path. And as you're watching this video, if you find it helpful, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up, and I'd like to invite you to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials. The Object on a Path tool is designed to take a group of objects that you select on your artboard and then apply them to a path which you will also select, and it can either be a closed path like a circle, square, or polygon, or it can be an open path which does not connect the start and the end anchors. Now, I've colored my one here, the red color, because I want you to see the point of origin where Illustrator places the first of the objects in a group, and it's going to be different depending on the shape that you're applying the objects to. For a circle, Illustrator will always apply the first object in the group to the right center anchor of the circle. On a square or a rectangle, it'll apply the first object in the bottom right corner. And on polygons, it will depend on how many sides you have. In this example, we have the point of origin as the top right anchor. Now, when we move to the open paths, the first anchor that you place on the artboard to draw out your line is going to be the point of origin. In this example, I drew left to right, so my point of origin is on the left side. But in this example, I drew right to left, so my point of origin is on the right side. However, this tool always moves left to right. So because I drew right to left, Illustrator recognizes this path as being upside down, and it even places each of the objects on that path upside down as well. Now, to find out how Illustrator decides the order of the objects after that point of origin, I'm going to move to another document and actually show you how the tool works. Now, what I have here is two rows of circles, and I've made certain that the circles on the bottom row are directly in line vertically with these top circles. I'm going to select our circles, and I'll hold down the Option key and drag out a copy of them. And then I'll move to the left toolbar. This is our new icon, Objects on a Path. I'll click here. All of the objects are selected, and my cursor is prompting me to click on a target path, which is going to be this circle here. So I'll click on the path, and immediately Illustrator arranges the objects around the circle clockwise, starting with my point of origin right here. Well, how did it determine to go from the one to the solid red? This tool, as I said before, moves from left to right. So it's going to start on the left side. But in addition to left and right, it also goes top to bottom. So if there are two objects that are directly in the same vertical line, it's going to consider these a column. So it's going to go one, and then the next object in the column would be the solid red. Then it'll move to the next object closest to the left, and it'll choose top to bottom, and so forth, all the way across the artboard. But what if the objects are not in a nice, neat order? Well, let's see what happens. I'm going to select these objects and delete them, move to the Layers panel, and I'm going to reveal some random numbers here. Notice that the red one is on the far left of the artboard. It is below the two, but it's still the furthest left. Then with the two and three, these are in the same vertical line, so Illustrator ought to choose them going one, two, three. Then will come four, five, and notice the six, even though it's above the seven is actually a little to the left of it, so I predict it's going to go five, 7, 6, and then 8. So let's see what happens. I'll select my objects, and I'm also going to select my target path. You can actually select all of these at once, and it just saves you a step. So I'll release my mouse, come over and click on the objects on a path icon. Then I'll come over and click on the target path, and let's see what we have. We do start on the right center again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and as predicted, the 7, which was a little to the left of the 6, is arranged before the 6, and then we have 8 as the last number. So that's how Illustrator determines how it orders the objects. Another thing to note is with the object on a path tool, it's different than the type on a path tool in that when you place text on a path, the actual path is not going to be visible. But with this tool, we still have the attributes of our circle. And if I had a fill color, that would remain as well. Now let's look at how we edit these objects once they're on the path. I'll move to the Properties panel and we'll select the path. And when I do, the Object on Path Options area of the Properties panel becomes visible. And we'll talk about these functions in a minute. But I want to talk about the widgets first. Now, if your path looks a little different than mine, you probably have bounding boxes turned on. And you can toggle those on and off by going up to View. I'm going to click Show Bounding Box here. Keyboard shortcut is Shift Command B. And now we have the bounding box, and our top widget is attached to the box. So let's look at the first widget. This is the space widget. If I click on it and drag to the right, nothing happens on the path. But next to my cursor is the little text box, which tells me how far apart each one of the objects are placed. If I drag to the left, Illustrator is going to begin moving those objects towards my point of origin. Notice that the point of origin is locked in place. And I can move the objects all the way to right on top of that point of origin. Notice spacing is 0 inches, or I can drag them around. Illustrator will keep them evenly spaced no matter where I place them on the artboard. Next, the widget at the bottom is the Rotate All widget, and it's pretty self-explanatory. I can just grab it and move to the left or move to the right. You can see the text box is telling me the value of the angle. If I wanted to type in a specific angle, I merely come over to the Objects on a Path Options area here, and let's highlight this, and I'll type in 45 degrees and press the return key. And now each one of the objects is turned at 45 degrees. And then I can come back and change this to 0 if I want, press the return key, and they're back in their original positions. Speaking of placement, by default, Illustrator defines the attachment point of each of the objects as their center point. And we can change that by coming over to the Properties panel and changing the pivot point. So right now, the center of this little square is selected. This is our attachment point on each of the objects. If I choose the top left pivot point, even though these are circles instead of squares, Illustrator uses an imaginary top left corner. And notice how our object's attachment point has changed. If I change this to the bottom right, Illustrator changes the attachment point to the bottom right. And if we come back to center, each of the objects is centered again, and that's probably the way you'll want to leave this. However, if you wanted to change the default setting, you could come over and double-click on the icons. I'll double-click to open the Objects on the Path Tool Options dialog box. And here, I can click any one of these pivot points. I'm going to choose the top left. I can even change the angle that the objects will be placed on the path by typing in a number here. So I'm going to type in 45 degrees, and then I'll click Save. Now, nothing happened to the current path that we have created, but the next path will reflect those changes. Now, if you make that change in the default setting and then you decide you want to go back, you can do that by double-clicking again on the tool. And if you don't remember what the settings were, it doesn't matter. All you have to do is click reset and save. And now you're back to the default setting. Now, notice my cursor now has a little circle with a hash mark on it, and I'm not going to be able to do anything. And that's because I was working with those default options. So what I'll have to do is come over and get the selection tool, and then I can come back over and I'm able to work with my path. The other thing I do want to mention is that as I was preparing for this tutorial and using the object on a path tool over and over and over again, two times my entire software crashed. So it's a good thing to remember when you start a new project, the first thing you should do is save it, give it a name, and then save often. The next widget is on the point of origin. So let's click on the path, and then you'll notice there's a little diamond on my red one. When I hover over it, it becomes solid. And if I click down and I drag up, or I drag down, Illustrator is going to move all of the objects, even the point of origin, in the direction that I'm dragging. And it's going to maintain that same spacing all the way around the circle. So let's move this up to the top and I'll release my mouse. So Illustrator does give us a way to rotate all of the objects around our path. Now let's see what happens if I want to delete an object on a path. I'm going to click on the three here and press the delete key, and that definitely isn't what I wanted. I didn't want to delete the whole thing, so we'll undo that move, Command Z or undo clear here, and notice that each one of these objects also has a little widget in it right in the center. And when I hover over one of them, it says select move. Well, I'm going to click down on the three. And when I do, the detach button in the properties panel becomes active. So if I want to get rid of the three, I click on detach. Now the three is still where it was before, but all of the other objects have moved and I can actually grab the three and move it away, and the remaining objects are evenly spaced around my path. Now, if I decide after I've detached it that I wanted the three on the path after all, well, I can't just come back and put it on by dragging onto the path. I've got to go to the layers panel, and I'm going to twirl open this random section, because in here I have my three on a path and I have the objects on a path that are right here. We can see as I click on that, they're selected. Well, I'm going to click on this three and I'm going to drag the three onto the objects on a path. See how it's highlighted as I'm on top of it, and release my mouse, and Illustrator adds the three back onto the path. Now it didn't put it in order. It put it after the last object. Remember, these are in order. The last object was an eight. So the three is placed between the eight and the one, but that's not a problem. I'll select the path, click on the three widget and drag it in between the two and the four, and I don't have to try to center it. Illustrator will take care of that for me when I release my mouse. So now my numbers are back in order. What I find interesting is that when I shuffled the objects, Illustrator actually changed the point of origin from that red one to the two. Just something else to keep an eye on. Now I can actually add any object to this path, even one that wasn't previously on there. Let's just reveal these hearts here. I'll twirl this open and select one of the hearts, and I'm going to click on it and drag it onto our objects on a path. Now remember, our two became the point of origin, so coming around the circle, one is the last object on the circle, so Illustrator places the heart here after the last object. So that's how that works. Now I'll delete this path, and I'm going to get the pencil tool, keyboard shortcut in and drag out a curvy path. Let's just grab hold of these hearts and hold down the shift key to select the path. Come over and click on the objects on a path icon, then choose the path again. Illustrator spreads the hearts out from the starting anchor to the ending anchor. I'll click on the space widget. If I drag to the right, there's no place to go, but if I drag to the left, Illustrator is going to move the objects toward that point of origin, which was the starting place. And then what I can do is click on the Move All widget and drag these around anywhere I want on the path. And using different designs may be the most useful and fun way to use this tool. Let's create another circle for the last thing I'm going to show you. I'll reveal my flowers here and select the flowers and our path. Click on the objects on a path. Click on the circle. We'll go to the spacing and drag everything close together here on the left. And then I'll click on the Move All widget and drag this around to center these objects. And here I have a nice circle with a design around the bottom. And finally, if you decide you want to make some changes to your path after you've created it, you can do that in one of two ways. You can either twirl open the path, select individually the path, come over to the properties panel, and I'll change the fill color to yellow. And I could select any one of these flowers in their groupings and make some changes as well, but it does get a little trickier. Now, if you want full control over the colors and the strokes, select the object, go up to Object, and choose Expand. And we're going to expand the objects, the fill and the stroke, and say OK. Then I've got to ungroup these. So we go to Object and ungroup all. And now I'm able to select any object individually, but I've lost the ability to use that object on a path tool to rotate these flowers around. Well, I do hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about this new tool, the Objects on a Path tool. I do want to remind you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.